I don't blame you.
Yeah, I don't.
You know what?
You haven't been on a what?
A plane since 1974.
Yeah, you know what?
Break that in.
When you walk down these days and you look at the...
They built in 74.
Yeah.
They're riding the same hardware.
Yeah. No, if anything, I've shrunk. I'm not grown.
Yeah,
and last time I took a plane, all you had to do was give me a ticket. And they put you on a plane. Now you gotta, take your clothes off, take your shoes. I was waiting for, you want to bend over the car?
That's called a cabin service.
So someone said, how was the procedure? I said, it was easier than going to the yard in Supermax. I don't even know what I'm on. No, I'm not on the innocent court. They didn't get me out. I didn't work for Lisa.
She
freed me, man. She's my person.
Lisa was free.
Same age as my daughter, 45.
Wow. Didn't know at 45?
But she's only been doing the innocence work for what, 8 years, 9 years now?
Yeah, she came on after mine.
Right.
And that was her first time.
Oh.
Yeah. And she said the brief she submitted for me was the best thing she's ever written. And I know the introduction is what freed me. Not the facts, not the law, nothing. It was her introduction. It was unbelievably good. It just, because, it's a prison murder case, so it's real convoluted. I got jailhouse informants,
right.
Lying screws,
right.
DA suppressing
it works.
Evidence.
It works.
Yeah, everything they can do, because you're a stinking convict. They don't care. And, man, she wove this story that is unfucking believable. Everybody that has read it said, when's the movie coming out? Where's the book? I did 45 and a half.
Yo, give me a second.
Years.
Okay. And I stayed here till after he left. And then I followed him out the door.
That's right. That's right, man. So, we're going to talk to a lot more people, man, but I got my man Ray Champagne, people that are grew up under him and with him, So, we really have to make that. Upthatradio.com is going to have some exclusive, the innocent convict.org.
So, you said you spent 45 years,
5 months.
Wow.
Went in when I was 19 and turned 65, 26 days after I got out.
Wow.
So I missed a few years.
Wow.
I'm trying to make up for it now.
Man, welcome back home.
It's good. I've been out a little over 2 years, like a month or two. I got out February 18th, 2020, just in time for COVID to hit.
Dang.
That helped me because the streets in Chelsea were empty.
Yeah.
So I'd go to my partner's program. She runs a youth program.
Yeah.
And I volunteer there.
Mm-hmm.
And when I first started going, the streets were packed in Chelsea. It's an immigrant community. It's just always in transition, the next load of immigrants that come through.
Yeah.
And when COVID hit, if I saw five people on my way walking in, it was crowded.
Yeah.
It was like crazy. But it helped me because I go in a store, there'd be five people. I'm talking supermarket.
So that helped with the transition.
I didn't have to deal with it. I did most of my time. I did 39 years in max.
Wow.
So I really didn't do a lot of media time.
Mm-hmm.
My last 21 was in Shirley Max.
Yeah.
You're just in a cell by yourself, man.
Right.
Wow.
And there was 23 hours locked up. So, you're used to being by yourself. And I never went to jail. It's like, it sucks.
Yeah.
Prison for years. And so I needed that space without all them people there. And it actually, so COVID was beneficial to me. Unfortunately, I didn't get it. A lot of people did. A lot of guys in the joint.
God damn.
I don't know if you're from here.
I'm from here. Yeah. I live in Phoenix.
A guy named Joe Messer.
Okay.
We called him Cement. He was a knucklehead on one level, but he was a good contact.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But real hard.
Yeah.
But he, like me and Diamond, we all litigated. We were all litigated.
Right.
This poor bastard did 41 or 42 years. Got COVID, and died. The warden he had was going for a medical release, and the commissioner said, "I think he's fine," and he died 3 days later.
Thank you.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's like they just don't care.
Yeah, this guy here. Diamond, you remember Joe Mesery?
Yeah.
Cemented? I was just telling him how he died because the warden said, "No, I think he's lying." And then we got
chicken sandwich with the other chicken sandwich with coleslaw.
Dessert, then you
get. She called him a liar, and 3 days later, he was dead.
Got any good stories of Joe you want to share?
I got a bunch of stories. You know, the good stories you can't share because people are still under threat.
But you want regular,
just, you know, it's prison. You know, I don't care what state you're in.
Mm-hmm.
It's all the same. They treat us all like we're garbage.
Right.
We're all slaves of the state.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care what color you are. It don't matter. We're all just... We're below whatever is out here. We're below that, and that's how they treat you. And anybody that does that knows that. You know, Diamond will tell you I was never about race, white guy, black guy. Anything I ever did that was organized, whether it was a hunger strike, always had the black guy, Spanish guy, because everybody, you got to have a voice.
Right.
And I can't speak for what a black convict is going through, nor a Spanish convict, nor a woman prisoner.
Yeah.
You know, you can only speak for who you are. And so, you know, sadly, unity in prison is, sometimes you see it, and when you see it nowadays, it's real heartwarming. I hate to say it, man. You almost want to cry when you see it. Because convicts don't stand up for each other, man. Whatever the enemy is for, I'm against. Whatever they're against, I'm for. And that holds doubly true in prison.
We know when to unite. We can be in the middle of a race. That's why I want to stand
right
here. We can be in the middle of a race riot, and we will pause in the middle if the other side pop up or come with some nonsense.
To handle business, man. And that's why the swine have the control they have now, because we allow it. You know, and, you know, it's harder nowadays to do the damage we did in the 60s and 70s. I mean, I started out as a juvenile during time, so, you know, I've had probably a total, barring the 2 years I've been exonerated, I probably have 15 months on the street since I was 13.
Wow.
Ray Champagne, just like the alcohol, C-H-A-M-P-A-G-N-E.
Thank you, Ray, man. God bless
you. Absolutely. You guys be well.